អង្គុយចុះអង្គជម្រាបប្រកាសបន្តកិច្ចដំណើរការនៃនីតិវិធីសមាគមនិងផ្ដល់វិធានការជូនទៅក្រមមេធាវីកាពីក្រីលោកចំនួនជាដើម្បីមានឱកាសតទំនួទៅតាមសំណួរនេះដល់ចំពោះសាក់សីរូបនេះសូមអញ្ជើញ
សូមអរគុណលោកប្រធានខ្ញុំនៅមានសំណួរតែ2-3ទៀតអស់ហើយនឹងបន្តទៅនេះសហភេតាខ្ញុំនឹងបន្តលោកសាក់សីខ្ញុំសូមសួរលោកបន្តតែ2-3សំណួរទៀតទេមានឯកសារចម្លើយរបស់សាក់ការសាក់សួររបស់ជាក្រុមសុំកិតលេខ E3-64លោកបានឆ្លើយថាតើសួរសំណួរសួរថាតើបងឌឿននិងបងយ៉ែមជាអ្នកណាពីហ្នឹងលោកឆ្លើយថាខ្ញុំមិនសូវដឹងច្បាស់ទេអំពីអ្នកទាំងពីរអ្នកនេះយ៉ែមអាចជាសមាជិកសភាចំណែកឌឿនប្រហែលជាសមាប្រធានមន្ទីរអ្វីមួយធ្វើការជាមួយនួនជាឬក៏ខៀវសំផនឬជាសមាជិកសភាទទួលបន្ទុកខាងភូមិភាគឧត្តរឃ្លារបស់លោកនេះលោកបាននិយាយពាក្យអាចនិងពាក្យប្រហែលនេះបញ្ជាក់ថាលោកមិនច្បាស់លាស់ទេគ្រាន់តែស្មានស្មានដែលពេលលោកឆ្លើយជាមួយនឹងជាក្រុមសើបអង្កេតតើការបកប្រែរបស់ខ្ញុំនេះត្រឹមត្រូវទេលោកគ្រាន់តែជាស្មានលោកមិនបានច្បាស់លាស់ទេលោកឆ្លើយជាមួយនឹងជាក្រុមសើបអង្កេតពីនោះ
បាទខ្ញុំបានឆ្លើយយ៉ាងដូច្នោះមែនពីព្រោះខ្ញុំប្រើពាក្យអាចនិងប្រហែលហើយដល់ខ្ញុំបានមកធ្វើសក្ខីកម្មនៅផ្ទាល់នៅកន្លែងតុលាការនេះបានខ្ញុំយល់ថាពាក្យអាចពាក្យស្មានពាក្យប្រហែលគឺពុំមែនជាការពិតទេដូច្នេះខ្ញុំក៏បានលើកសំណូមពរឲ្យអង្គសវនាការលុបចោលនៅពាក្យទាំងឡាយណាដែលខ្ញុំបានផ្ដល់បទសម្ភាសជូនចៅក្រមស៊ើបអង្កេតគ្រប់ពាក្យទាំងអស់នៅក្នុងបទសម្ភាសហ្នឹងដែលមានពាក្យប្រហែលពាក្យអាចពាក្យតាមខ្ញុំស្មានចេញទៅគុំទុកជាការពីព្រោះគឺខ្ញុំមិនដឹងបាទ
អរគុណលោកបានបំភ្លឺច្បាស់លាស់ចំពោះមុខនៅតុលាការខ្ញុំយល់ថានេះជាលើកទី2ដែលលោកបានបញ្ជាក់ខ្ញុំសូមសួរសំណួរមួយទៀតនៅក្នុងទំព័រដែលខ្ញុំបានសួរមិញទំព័រដដែលហ្នឹងពីនោះលោកចក្រមសួរថាតើនួនជាមានទំនាក់ទំនងអ្វីជាមួយសារទូរលេខនេះលោកឆ្លើយថាជាដំបូងទូរលេខនេះគឺបញ្ជូនទៅតែប៉ុលពតម្នាក់គត់ប៉ុន្តែដោយសារអ្នកគ្រប់គ្រងសារទូរលេខគាត់ដឹងថាបញ្ជានេះគឺត្រូវបញ្ជូនទៅអ្នកទទួលខុសត្រូវខាងប្រជាជនដោះស្រាយដូចជានួនជាជាដើមនេះត្រង់ចម្លើយរបស់លោកពីនោះថាបញ្ជានេះគឺត្រូវបញ្ជូនទៅអ្នកទទួលខុសត្រូវខាងប្រជាជនដើម្បីដោះស្រាយដូចជានួនជាជាដើមនេះតើមានន័យថាយ៉ាងម៉េចក្នុងឃ្លានេះបើលោកនួនជាគ្រាន់តែជាប្រធានសភាប្រជាជនតែប៉ុណ្ណោះហេតុអ្វីបានជាហេតុអ្វីបាននួនជាអ្នកទទួលខុសត្រូវប្រជាជនទៅវិញបើលោកគ្រាន់តែជាប្រធានរដ្ឋសភា
បាទខ្ញុំមិនដឹងអស់អំពីកិច្ចការដែលខាងលោកប៉ុនគាត់ចាត់ចែងយ៉ាងម៉េចទេ có phần tái nè không sửa bằng kết ở khi em chui vì phía ở khi em chui bình dồn và chẳng hai khi em bình dồn là cứ không lấy thả về ái che tam man cho là cứ không khó nó có sông cài đấy cứ thả bây giờ xa nó mình bên chỉ tư được bọc nhom phong bây giờ tiết mình bên nhom chỉ nè chặt chay phong làm xa với nhá khi ông chui bình dương con thà không xa nắng về kê đạp nhà chun mật bằng pol mà còn tại riêng nắng về làm xa dương mưa tứ cứ thà mình bên tại bằng pol mình anh thế để miền sất để trâu tụt tuôn xa nâng anh ấy chỉ tam khi ông sman prap chào cầm sự ủng kết nâng chẳng hay ban chia cầm nè chặt chay tu lễ kỳ chấm ná đã thả bong nuôn nô và cứ hết phần chăng và tại ở chấp ba thạc khi ông tha xa nâng cứ trâu tụt chun bong nuôn lắm nó an thành chăng cứ khi nhóm ở chỗ bà thế, nên cứ chia ca vì phía thế bà chia ca chui phần dôn lên bà khi nhóm ảnh phần dôn bàn tại phần đăng thế bà
khi nhóm xâm nuôi trong cầu bà bọc khi nhóm xô thà bì mà xâm mênh mê thư vi đàm răng rọt bà đi bàn xô lục thà bà mình nè khó nâng xa là thò xung cùng cái thưa mạch lúc bàn xoay thả tư đại lúc xoay cho bố mục cho gom xương cất đúng lúc xoay thả bình chun tự ái bà mình bánh hát khó xa là thò tệ tông tư nôn chia tư vinh bà lúc nôn chia chỉ bật thiên cho phía xó mấy câu cục cọng hướng sơn la thoi na đâu vinh anh ấy xâm lược chui bẩn lưu trong năng phong
nhóm oai lô cơ xong oai lô bình đất chậm lại chúng ta miền đặc nhóm prapia saman rư ai đại thế xong xong tiếng thuật chậm lại bậc nhóm từ chấm muối năng chào cầm sự bằng kết
Your Honour, two points of order. First of all, counsel is referring to portions of the statement and references to exhibits. He should provide the correct exact ERNs and document numbers so we can all follow. Secondly, I didn't object the first time, but I will object now. My learned friend is misrepresenting his client's positions during the period. I believe his client has himself accepted that he held the position of Deputy Secretary of the CPK to be putting to the witness a proposition that is simply not true is improper, and it leads to confusion and potentially incorrect evidence being introduced. So I would just say on that second point, if my friend wishes to put to the witness his client's positions, then he should state them in full and not misrepresent that Nguyen Chia was merely the president of the People's Representative Assembly, because that is not the case.
របស់នួនជាជាប្រធានសភាតំណាងប្រជាជនខ្ញុំសូមឆ្លើយទៅសហប្រិញ្ញាខ្ញុំបានយោងទៅលើបាននិយាយអំពីតុលាការអំពីលេខឯកសាររួចហើយហើយពេលនោះມັນមានចំទាស់ទេខ្ញុំបាននិយាយអំពីអង្គសេចក្តីទៅតាំងពី 1 ដែលសំណួរទី 1 ចុងក្រោយបំផុតនេះនិងសំណួរទី 2 ដូចគ្នាថានៅក្នុងឯកសារដដែលប៉ុន្តែសំណួរ វាខុសខុសគ្នាហើយខ្ញុំថាសំណួររបស់ខ្ញុំសាក់សីបានឆ្លើយបំភ្លឺហើយគ្រាន់តែចង់ក្រោយមកផុតនេះសំណួរចង់ក្រោយមកផុតរបស់ខ្ញុំនេះលោកគ្រាន់សួរមកខ្ញុំវិញថាលោកមិនច្បាស់ថាតើលោកបាននិយាយមានពាក្យប្រហែលទេឬអីចឹងខ្ញុំមិនទាន់បានឆ្លើយផងប៉ុន្តែលោកប្រញ្ញាជំទាស់មានន័យថាជំទាស់ក្រោយសាក់សីបានឆ្លើយហើយសូមអរគុណខ្ញុំអស់សំណួរប៉ុណ្្នឹងសូមអរគុណលោកសាក់សី
លោកមេធាវីអន្តរជាតិកាលពីក្រោយលោកនគាមានត្រូវបន្តតាំងសំណួរទៀតទេបើមានសូមអញ្ជើញ
Thank you, Mr. President. Good afternoon, everyone. Good afternoon, Mr. Witness. I do have some questions. Mr. Witness, good afternoon. I, along with Major Sun Arun, the gentleman who just asked you questions, I represent Nuon Chia. I have some further questions I'd like to put to you. And before I do that, just let me begin, by thanking you. I'd like to thank you not only for coming here to answer all of these questions. I know it's been a long time, it's been a hard task. But also, I'd like to thank you for telling us, as you've done so many times since you've been here, over and over, in fact, if and when you don't know something, when you don't know the answer to a particular question. And just let me say that we're grateful for that kind of candor. Now, if I could just start with something which hopefully will save me some time and allow me to finish today, so I don't have to continue into tomorrow. I'd just like to confirm one or two things with you. And I'm doing this only so that I can properly understand your evidence and so that it's very clear for me on the record. So first of all, you've told us that although there was a system in place at the base level, and in particular at the zones, I think you said, to confirm the receipt of telegrams once they've been sent out from K-18, I believe, you yourself told us that you could not confirm whether those telegrams were actually sent were always received. And I just want to make sure I have that correct, that you yourself were not in a position to confirm whether all the telegrams that were sent out were received. Have I got you right?
បាទត្រឹមត្រូវណាស់ព្រោះនឹងវាហួសពីសមត្ថភាពដែលខ្ញុំត្រូវតាមដានហ្នឹង
Thank you very much, Mr. Witness. And something else, which I believe you told us was beyond your ability, and I'm asking now so that I can confirm it. And this is something you said this morning in response to a question by my colleagueOn my right, Mr. Kong Sam On for the Kyusan Han team. I believe what you told him was that in actual fact, you didn't know whether any of the telegrams that you dealt with reached their intended recipients. You didn't know that for a fact. You can't confirm that. Did I get you right on that point? You didn't know whether telegrams actually reached their intended recipients.In particular, those people whose names were on the telegrams. Is that correct? Thank you. And just one last question on this point, just to be crystal clear, as my friend across the stage would say.Is it fair to say that the outer limit of your field of knowledge, that is, the things that you yourself would personally know about, with respect to those telegrams you told us about that were placed in envelopes that were labeled K1, is it fair to say that the outer limit of your knowledge as to the fate of those telegrams was that guard booth or that box?That you described in front of K1 on several occasions. Is that correct?
បាទមិនមែនដាក់ក្នុងប្រអប់មួយនៅកន្លែងរោងយាមមុខខមមួយនោះទេគឺថាពេលនិរសាខាងខ្ញុំបញ្ជូនទៅគឺជូនទៅដល់អ្នកដែលប្រចាំការនៅកន្លែងរោងយាមមុខខមមួយនឹងហើយបាទមិនមែនជាប្រអប់សម្បត្តិដែលទុកចោលប្រមាណម៉ោងប្រមាណម៉ោងដែលបានគេមកបោកបើកមើលម្ដងដូចជាក្រុមសម្បត្តិធម្មតាតាមប្រិយសនីនោះទេគឺគេយកទៅភ្លាមមានអ្នកប្រចាំការនៅមុខនោះគេយកទៅភ្លាមមក
So just so I understand you clearly, those envelopes that you described, which were labeled K1, they were deposited or dropped off outside of K1, and then somebody else took it from there. Is that correct?
Yes, correct.
ផ្លូវចេញចូលតកមួយហ្នឹងនៅមុខអាគារហ្នឹងមក
Thank you, Mr. Witness. And so what actually happened to those telegrams beyond that box, that was, as I believe you've told us, solely Pon's domain and not your own business. Do I have you correct?
អ្នកដែលយាមនៅកមួយនឹងគេនឹងយកបន្តទៅជូនលោកប៉ុនជាអ្នកចាត់ចែងបាទ
Thank you Mr. Witness that I believe will save me a great deal of time let me move on to one general item and then we'll eventually return to someaddition specific matters. My colleague, Major Sanarun, asked you a question already about those assumptions you referred to, and you gave us a very clear answer on how you thought the chamber should deal with those assumptions that you made to the OCIJ investigators. I'd like to ask you another question, a different question, about something you said about your time with those OCIJ investigators. And I think it's probably easier if I just quote from the draft transcript so I don't misstate and mischaracterize what you've said. And this was from yesterday's evidence, and I believe this is something that you said to one of the civil party lawyers, and I'm quoting now from the draft transcript, that's Tuesday, 4th of September, page 53, line 7, and you said, at the time, I did not know when these people disappeared or were removed, you said. The investigators tried to ask me this question time and again. I already stated very early that I did not know from the beginning. First, he asked me to explain about the removal of people, and I started to explain on this. But then more and more questions were bombarded on me, on Pong and Tay, and the statement could not be used as the evidence because, as I said, I didn't know, and I do not know what happened to the removal of people at the base. I do not know how this worked. Now, what I'm interested in is a phrase that you used in that bit of testimony. You mentioned that you were bombarded somehow by the investigators. What did you mean by that? Did you mean to say that at times during the time you spent with the investigators when you didn't know something or when you made it clear that you didn't know something that those investigators continued to press you with questions because they weren't satisfied with your answer or did you mean something else maybe you could explain to us what you meant by bombardment passage. And Mr. Witness, please don't answer it yet. My colleague is on his feet across the stage.
Your Honor, we... Your Honor, I'm reluctant to interrupt my learned friend's examination, but we would object on the basis of relevance. We've heard the first-hand evidence from the witness. We've heard his explanations as to the limits of his knowledge. We've heard his clarifications. We've also heard him confirm numerous parts of his statements, and we've heard him provide clarification where clarification is necessary. We do not, we would submit that questions that go to the techniques adopted by the investigators in this instance are simply irrelevant. If my learned friend wishes to test the witness's knowledge by reference to the prior statement, ask what he meant in that statement and how that differs from what he says today, that's entirely appropriate. But questions about techniques and questions asked in an OCIJ interview are irrelevant. We have the witness here and we can deal with the facts with the witness.
If I may just briefly respond, obviously I take a completely different position. It has long been our position that those very techniques that the investigators used during the investigation, the propriety of those techniques, the substance of those techniques, the style of those, all those things, as we've said time and again, are relevant, relevant to the question of the quality of the evidence that is now put before your chamber in terms of these witness statements, many of which, based on your rulings, we are going to be relying on in some form or another without calling witnesses, without adversarial testing. So it is our firm position that these techniques are clearly relevant. They're relevant to the quality of the OCIJ investigation. And I think this witness, he's here, he's sitting with us, he's told us about a bombardment. I think he can very easily tell us what he meant by that. It could be that it's completely innocuous, and he would be the one to tell us.
Good afternoon, Mr. President. Good afternoon, Your Honors, and good afternoon to everyone in and around the courtroom. I wish to support the response provided by counsel for Nuon Chea and wish to add the following. The events happened nearly 40 years ago. How the investigation was conducted in taking the summary, what was done in that process to assist the gentleman in remembering events, showing him documents that may have refreshed or created memory. These sorts of techniques are the sort of areas that we are entitled to explore because it goes to the credibility of the witness's actual memory and his understanding of the events at the time when they occurred with the knowledge that he had at that time and not the knowledge that he may have been provided by the investigators. This is a line of questioning that was pursued in the past. Obviously, the prosecution would like to have any inappropriate conduct related to investigations not be explored for all the obvious reasons. We think this is an absolute necessary process. It's done before all the other tribunals. We're using international standards. There's no reason why we should not be able to use these same standards in this courtroom here. Thank you.
Très brièvement, donc je voudrais également soutenir la position qui vient d'être énoncée par mes deux confrères. Votre procès est la preuve qu'il est essentiel d'avoir des règles lorsque l'on entend une personne, des règles d'honnêteté et de technicité du questionnement. Nous avons vu tout à l'heure, pour ce qui concerne cette personne, et nous l'avons déjà vu par le passé, qu'en plus de cela, il semble, si l'on en croit les procès-verbaux, un procès-verbal d'audition, que les enquêteurs aient rencontré ce monsieur avant même le 18 février et qu'il n'y ait ni enregistrement, ni procès-verbal de cette rencontre, alors même que les faits étaient évoqués avec le témoin. Donc je crois que c'est véritablement capital pour la bonne tenue de ce procès et je soutiens la demande de mon confrère.
I was just about to explain that. What I was about to say was, with your leave, I would like to add one very brief additional point, and I promise not to make a habit of this, but I think something that needs to be said is this sense that we're dealing with a cured investigation, that the closing order cured the faults, any faults there may have been in the investigation. We've been here for almost a year now, and I think we can all point to numerous occasions of what I will call irregularities, where statements don't match, we get audio recordings that are off by several hours. I think we've passed the point of rebutting any presumption of regularity that attaches to the judicial investigation, and I think that's a point that needs to be made. These are serious issues. We can't test all this evidence. We don't have time. This was one of the things that was one of the main topics at the trial management meetings. We're running out of time. We don't have time to test this evidence. Even today, the point I raised this morning, we get a transcript of a witness statement who's been on the stand for 3 days. After he's been on the stand for 3 days. So these things are happening after the fact on a very ad hoc basis, and I just want to make it clear that I don't think this chamber should attach any presumption of regularity to the OCIJ's investigation, and I apologize for not saying that the first time. As I said, I won't make a habit of adding comments at the end.
ទី 1 យើងរំលឹកឡើងវិញយើងបានកត់សម្គាល់បញ្ហានេះញឹកញាប់ហើយទី 1 បញ្ជាក់នៅក្នុងការជម្រាបប្រាប់អំពីករណីយកិច្ចសាក់សីនីមួយនីមួយក្នុងការផ្ដាល់តខ័យកម្មប្រសិនបើមិនច្រឡំទេលោកអាចវិនិច្ឆ័យមើលនៅការប្រាប់អំពីសិទ្ធិនិងករណីយកិច្ចសាក់សីនៅចំពោះមុខអង្គជំរះយើងបានប្រាប់ច្បាស់លាស់អំពីឲ្យគាត់ឆ្លើយតែការណាដែលពិតដែលគាត់បានដឹងបានឮបានឃើញការនឹងបានចងចាំបន្ថែមគឺបទពិសោធន៍ហើយនឹងការកត់សម្គាល់របស់គាត់ពាក់ព័ន្ធទៅនឹងអង្គហេតុព្រឹត្តិហេតុទាំងឡាយដែលតេតិននឹងសំណួរដែលភាគីឬអង្គជំរះបានសួរនេះជាកិច្ចការរបស់អង្គជំរះជាបន្តបន្ទាប់ទោះបីមិនមានការជំទាស់ក៏ដោយគឺយើងតែងតែរំលឹកនិងប្រាប់ថាវាឥតមានតម្លៃទេប្រសិនបើការឆ្លើយដោយស្មានស្មានដោយការសន្និដ្ឋានប្រើពីអាចអីអញ្ចឹងព្រោះស័ក្តិសិទ្ធិមិនមែនជាអ្នកជំនាញដែលមានសិទ្ធិក្នុងការស្វែងយល់ហើយធ្វើដូចសន្និដ្ឋានវាតម្លៃអំពីព្រឹត្តិការណ៍ណាមួយជូនមកអង្គជំរះទេបញ្ហាមួយទៀតលោកបាននិយាយមិញគឺមានតារៈសំខាន់ណាស់អង្គជំរះជម្រាបច្រើនដងហើយថាបើមានបញ្ហាវាធ្ងន់ធ្ងរដល់ម្លឹងសូមឲ្យអស់លោករៀបចំនៅសំណើសុំរបស់លោកជាលិលិអសរដើម្បីបង្ហាញសពគ្រប់នៅក្នុងសំណើសុំរបស់លោកដើម្បីអង្គជំរះនឹងមានមូលដ្ឋានក្នុងការទៅពិចារណាលើអ្វីដែលជាតម្អាងហេតុរបស់លោកដើម្បីចេញក្តីសម្រេចកំណត់អំពីបញ្ហានេះដើម្បីដោះស្រាយបញ្ហាទូទៅតែម្ដងដោយសារនៅក្នុងសំណុំរឿងក្តីនេះវាមានឯកសារជាច្រើនវារាប់លានទំព័រឯណោះអញ្ចឹងយើងមិនអាចបែងចែកប្រភេទឯកសារនោះឲ្យបានច្បាស់លាស់ទេថាតើឯកសារនឹងវាមានប្រមាណបែបដែលយើងដោះស្រាយតែម្ដងឲ្យចប់នោះរហូតដល់ពេលនេះយើងមិនទាន់ដោះស្រាយបាននៅឡើយទេនៅតែមានបញ្ហាថ្មីថ្មីនៅឡើយទេប៉ុន្តែអង្គជំរះព្យាយាមដោះស្រាយម្ដងហើយម្ដងទៀតបញ្ហាឯកសារនេះរហូតដល់ថ្ងៃនេះក៏នៅតែមានបញ្ហាដដែលប៉ុន្តែស្ដាយណាស់ដោយសារលោកប្រាប់ពាក្យថាវាធ្ងន់ធ្ងរណាស់ប៉ុន្តែបែរជាលើកឡើងនៅពាក្យគ្រាន់តែការ តាំងសំណួរប៉ុណ្ណឹងគាត់ទៅជំទាស់ដល់មានការជំទាស់ពីថាវាអញ្ញាបានលើកឡើងថាវាធ្ងន់ធ្ងរបើវាជំងឺវាធ្ងន់ធ្ងរយ៉ាងនេះសូមឲ្យលោករៀបចំនៅរាជជាសំណើសុំជាឯកសារពាក់ព័ន្ធនឹងបញ្ហានេះប្រឈមនេះដើម្បីដោះស្រាយបញ្ហានេះបានជ្រះត្រឡះតែម្ដងអានេះជាការល្អប្រសើរ
Thank you for that clarification, Mr. President. Am I to understand that I should be putting replies to objections in writing? Is that what you've just told me? I asked a question. The prosecution objected on the grounds of relevance. I stood up to respond or to reply, to tell the chamber why I thought it was relevant.
ក្នុងសម្រាប់ឥឡូវនេះចំពោះបញ្ហានេះយើងមិនអនុញ្ញាតឲ្យសាក្សីនេះនៅរ៉ាំរៃរាប់អតីតទៀតទេនៅចំពោះមុខអង្គជំនុំជម្រះប៉ុន្តែយើងឆ្លើយតបអំពីមិននេះដោយសារលោកឆ្លៀតឱកាសនេះប្រើពាក្យពេចន៍វាសារៈសំខាន់នៃបញ្ហានេះវាយូរហើយវាច្រើនហើយឆ្លៀតឱកាសនេះទើបយើងបញ្ជូនលោកថាបើវាសំខាន់យ៉ាងដូច្នេះវាជំងឺនេះវាកើតឡើងគ្រប់ដំណាក់កាលគ្រប់សាកសីរបៀបនេះសូមឲ្យលោករៀបចំនៅជាលិលិអសរមកវាមានភាពម៉ត់ចត់ជាងវាមានតម្អាងហេតុច្បាស់លាស់ជាង
Thank you again for that clarification.
បាទដើម្បីដោះស្រាយបញ្ហាកំពុងតែប្រឈមនេះអង្គជំរះគលភិរៈជូនទៅលោកចក្រមតង្មាក់ឡើងវិញដើម្បីឆ្លើយតបទៅនឹងបញ្ហាដែលកើតឡើងកំពុងតែកើតមានឡើងនេះហើយទៅទំនេះសូមឲ្យមេធាវីពាក់ព័ន្ធនឹងបញ្ហាតាំងទំនួចំពោះស័ក្តិសិទ្ធិរួមនេះសូមបថយល្បឿនរបស់ខ្លួនពីព្រោះមានការនិយាយញាប់នាំឲ្យការបកប្រែភាសាហ្នឹងបកពិបាកបកត្រាយពិបាកបកឲ្យបកមិនបានពេញលិញនៅខ្លឹមសារដែលលោកនិយាយសូមជួយលោកក្រុមសង្ឃមក
Oui, merci Monsieur le Président. La Chambre voulait d'abord rappeler qu'elle est saisie d'un certain nombre de requêtes qui, dès à présent, mettent en cause la régularité d'un certain nombre de méthodes d'interrogatoire. Et elle répondra bien évidemment à ces demandes écrites. Pour autant, il nous semble important que les questions qui sont posées à l'audience soient posées d'une façon ouverte, sans contenir en elles-mêmes des allégations selon lesquelles l'instruction aurait été diligentée d'une façon malhonnête, voire frauduleuse. Je pense qu'à ce stade, ce genre d'allégation est inapproprié. Donc vous êtes invité à poser des questions qui ne contiennent pas de telles suggestions et à poser des questions qui soient des questions ouvertes. Voilà, je pense que c'est ce qui était le plus important.
Thank you for that clarification, Director. I'd just like to add for the record, and I will speak very slowly. In my submission, I made a very measured submission, and I suggested that the answer from the witness could be an innocuous one. So I do take exception with the fact that I have impugned anyone's integrity ad hominem. I have not done that. I haven't named anyone by name. I haven't said this investigator is a bad person, the one who took that statement. I haven't said anything of the kind. So I do take exception to that ruling, just for the record. Just for the record. But I do note what you've said, and may I continue with, may the witness answer this question, or has the objection been ruled on? Thank you. Mr. Witness, coming back to what I said previously, I have the same question for you. What did you mean when you said that you felt you were bombarded by the OCIJ or the investigators? Could you please tell us what you meant by that? And please correct me if I'm misquoting you in any way, if that's not what you said.
បាទវាមានលក្ខណៈអញ្ចេះថាឧទាហរណ៍ថាប៉ងនិងថេហ្នឹងខ្ញុំក្នុងចម្លើយរបស់ខ្ញុំថាខ្ញុំមិនដឹងថាគាត់ទៅណាអីទេហើយគាត់នៅតែសួរថានរណាបាត់មុននរណាបាត់ក្រោយអីអានេះជាសំណួរទៅដែលខ្ញុំពិបាកនឹងឆ្លើយណាស់បាទគឺអញ្ចឹងទេបើមានថាខ្ញុំថាមិនដឹងទៅហើយគាត់ចង់សួរថាផងនឹងទេនឹងនរណាគេដកមុននរណាគេដកក្រោយនេះជាលក្ខណៈដែលថាគ្នាថាមិនដឹងហើយទៅថាមុនក្រោយណាទៀតបាទ
Thank you, Mr. Witness. So just so I have that clear, after you gave what you considered to be a clear answer to the OCIJ investigators, not calling for any further questioning on that point, they continued to question you and ask you questions that suggested that you may or should know those things. Have I got you right?
Come on, don't try that. That's right. Don't kill it. Come on, don't mind.
Maître Yanouzi, je pense que soit on a un problème de communication, soit vous ne cherchez pas à comprendre ce qu'on vous dit. Mais on vous dit que dans les questions que vous devez poser des questions ouvertes et non des questions où vous suggérez que les choses se sont passées de façon déloyale. Je crois que ça me paraît relativement simple. Vous voulez de suggérer exactement au témoin que la façon dont il a été interrogé était une façon qui était malhonnête.
Your Honor, the witness, it was the witness's answer that suggested that, and I was following up on the answer. That's all I was doing. That's what the witness said.
Maître, je ne pense qu'on n'est pas ici pour commenter ce que la Chambre vous répond à une objection, et vous êtes là pour appliquer les consignes qui vous sont indiquées.
Well, in that case, just so I clearly understand the instruction that was just meted out, I am not permitted to ask, or excuse me, I must ask an open question even when the answer from the witness is highly suggestive. Is that the ruling? Just so I have it clear, I don't want to offend you anymore.
Je crois qu'il ne faudrait peut-être pas surinterpréter la façon dont le témoin répond. Il faudrait aussi avoir une certaine conduite à l'audience qui soit à peu près loyale.
Thank you, Judge Levin. I'll move on to my next question on the same topic. Mr. Witness, one of the first things you did, in this courtroom when you appeared on Wednesday of last week, I believe it was, you confirmed, in response to a question from the President, the content in its entirety of both of your statements to the OCIJ investigators. Do you recall that? Certainly. As I recall, one of the first, let me take it step by step. Do you remember your first day of testimony before the chamber? That was last Wednesday. That is Wednesday of last week. I'm sorry, Mr. Witness, I can rephrase it again if you're still unclear.
ខ្ញុំមិនច្បាស់មែនមិនដឹងថាពួកសំណួរគឺវាមានច្រើននៅនឹងជាលោកចង់និយាយថាកាលពីថ្ងៃពុទ្ធដំបូងហ្នឹងចង់សួរថាសំណួរអីហើយ ខ្ញុំ បាន ឆ្លើយ មែន គឺ ប៉ុន្តែ មិន ដឹង សំណួរ អី ខ្លះ ទេ បាទ មិន ចង់ ចាំ ទេ
Indeed, Mr. Witness, you are correct, and it's late in the day, and I apologize for my lack of clarity. The very first individual who put questions to you was the President of the Chamber. Do you remember that? Thank you. And do you remember, as I recall, and tell me if I'm wrong, one of the questions he asked you was whether or not you had reviewed the two statements you gave to the CIJ investigators pursuant to the normal policy in this court whereby witnesses are given their statements to review in advance of testimony.
បាទលោកប្រធានបានសួរខ្ញុំដូច្នោះមែនបាទឲ្យខ្ញុំពិនិត្យចឹងមែនហើយខ្ញុំពិនិត្យទៅក៏ឃើញថាវាស៊ីគ្នាបាទអត់មានអីប្រែប្រួលទេ
Thank you. And then I believe, as a follow-up question, he asked you if you confirmed the contents of those statements in their entirety, if you stood by what you had said completely in those statements. And as I recall, you said yes, but please correct me if I'm wrong.
Thank you. And then I believe, as a follow-up question, he asked you if you
Thank you, Mr. Witness. Now, again, at several points over the course of your testimony over these last few days, you have, and I'm not going to characterize this in any way, so let me just say, at times, you've said that certain portions of your statements should not be relied upon, should not be used in evidence. And I believe you very clearly indicated that those portions related to places where you felt you had made assumptions. Is that correct?
បាទខ្ញុំបានប្រកាសហើយប្រកាសទៀតថាសូមអោយអស់លោកទាំងអស់ពិនិត្យមើលចម្លើយដែលចៅក្រមស៊ើបអង្កេតចំពោះពាក្យណាដែលខ្ញុំឆ្លើយថាអាចឬក៏ប្រហែលឬមួយក៏តាមប៉ាន់ស្មានណាសូមកុំអោយអស់លោកទាំងអស់យកចម្លើយរបស់ខ្ញុំនេះថាជាចម្លើយដែល
Thank you, Mr. Witness, and correct me if I'm wrong. Is that because the President of the Chamber explained to you what it meant to make assumptions, what it meant to use qualified language, like perhaps, like maybe? Is that why you made those later statements? Because the chamber explained what it meant to make an assumption?
បាទខ្ញុំលោកប្រធានបានដាស់តឿនខ្ញុំប្រហែលជាថ្ងៃទី2ចាំខ្ញុំចាំហ្នឹងគឺមុននឹងចូលប្រជុំភ្លាមលោកប្រធានដាស់តឿនខ្ញុំភ្លាមហើយក៏ខ្ញុំយកចិត្តទុកដាក់ ក្នុងចម្លើយរបស់ខ្ញុំគឺមិនអោយមានពាក្យស្មានមានពាក្យប្រហែលនឹងទៀតទេបាទខ្ញុំបានចងចាំ
Thank you, Mr. Witness. And maybe this could be my last question for the day. When you gave those statements to the OCIJ, did anyone who was there taking the statement explain to you or tell you not to make assumptions?
មិនមានការបញ្យលជាក់លាក់ដោយលោកប្រធានបានប្រាប់ខ្ញុំនឹងទេគាត់ថាអ្វីដែលពិតបាទបានយើងនិយាយដែលយើងបានដឹងច្បាស់ឬច្បាស់ឬក៏មានបទពិសោធន៍ដែលធ្លាប់ឆ្លងកាត់បាទពាក្យនេះគឺចៅក្រមសិស្សបង្កេតបានមុននឹងចាប់ដើមធ្វើសំណួរអីក៏លោកបានលោកអនុសាសន៍ហើយបាទ
Thank you, Mr. Witness. Your Honor, I don't mean to be presumptuous myself, but is this a good time to stop? I'm not finished. I would like to continue tomorrow.
Bạn trong một ngày sẽ bận tay ta ta cùi chụp tấm lưng cái dòng mạch để lục tiền.
ដោយការដំណោះស្រាយត្រូវកែតម្រូវកំហុសនៃការមិនគោរពវិធានបញ្ញត្តិក្នុងការស៊ើបសួរគ្មានបញ្ហាណាមួយដែលពាក់ព័ន្ធនឹងកំហុសនីតិវិធីបែបនេះអាចត្រូវបានលើកឡើងនៅចំពោះមុខអង្គជំនុំជម្រះរដ្ឋាភិបាលកម្ពុជាឡើយ សូមតន្តែចាប់អារម្មណ៍ទៅហើយពិចារណាហើយបើសិនជាមានបញ្ហានិតិអាចដោះស្រាយនៅថ្ងៃស្អែកទៀតបាទអរគុណលោកវិទ្យាវិអរគុណសាក់សីកិច្ចដំណើរការសម្ដែងការសម្រាប់ថ្ងៃនេះដល់ពេលសម្រាប់ហើយអញ្ញាបកាសសម្អាកិច្ចដំណើរការសម្ដែងការសម្រាប់ថ្ងៃនេះត្រឹមនេះសម្ដែងការលើកទៅបន្តធ្វើនៅថ្ងៃស្អែកហើយប្រហោះទី6ខែកញ្ញាឆ្នាំ2012 ដែលចាប់ផ្ដើមពីម៉ោង9ព្រឹកទៅសម្ដែងការនៅថ្ងៃស្អែកនេះអង្គជំរះនឹងបន្តស្ដាប់តក្កកម្មសាក់សីនៅសុផុងដែលនឹងសួរដេញដោលដោយក្រុមមេធាវីការពារក្តីលោកនួនជានិងក្រុមមេធាវីការពារក្តីលោកអៀងសេរីសូមសាធារណជននិងភាគីជ្រាបលោកនងសុផុងការស្ដាប់តក្កកម្មរបស់លោកនៅមិនទាន់ចប់នៅឡើយទេសម្ដែងការត្រូវបន្តនៅថ្ងៃស្អែកទៀតដូច្នេះអង្គជំរះសូមអញ្ជើញលោកមកបន្តផ្ដាល់តក្កកម្មនៅថ្ងៃស្អែកទៀតដោយចាប់ផ្ដើមពីម hơi hay mân trai rốt bà tà la ca xong tâm rộng vô chứ mươi nâng mân trai còn ông có phép công phía xã xây nâng nạ chung ní trong cái chung xã xây đúng ní vô tà lọc tự căn tà lây nè cột xã nơi vinh hay ở trên con tà lọc một căn cà lây bắt đầu thật khai căm được không phụ tục xã mạng ca nơi vinh nè bật ngay tay nơi vô liên mong phụng buồn bộ cọp ai nổ rẻ mặt tì khung kháng nòm luôn chung cho cháu nằm bày rút tà lọc tờ mặt tì khung kháng nơi ở vô tà co bình chốc hay ở nòm
សូមជញ្ជក់ចោល